Bachelor Nation, our hearts are breaking today because Ben Higgins and Lauren Bushnell have announced their split. You goddamn piece of garbage. This is a sad day for Bachelor Nation. You guys know, or maybe you don't know, I am an avid Bachelor fan. Shut up, Sophie. I watch every Monday, and I really believed in their love story for Ben and Lauren until they released their reality show following their time on The Bachelor that said happily ever after question mark. Because I feel like if there's a question mark, yeah, you know, when you're engaged, you don't really want the question mark to be there. It wants to be a little bit more of a done deal. In any case, they have released a statement to People. They said, "It is with heavy hearts that we announce our decision to go our separate ways. We feel fortunate for the time we had together and will remain friends with much love and respect for one another. We wish nothing but the best for each other and ask for your support and understanding at this time." So,
is it really with heavy hearts?
Yes, I think it is with heavy hearts. They tried to make it work. They were together for, I think, about maybe a little bit over a year, but they never set a wedding date, which was already one of those red flags. Also, you may recall that Ben, in the final episode, he told Lauren that he loved her, and then he also told JoJo that he loved her, and apparently that came up because Lauren was like, "How can you say that you love two people, but then you propose to one to spend the rest of your life with one person, but you said that you loved another person? That doesn't just go away. Love is not just like a heart switch, if you will." But the reason why this comes is a little bit of a surprise, and thank you for holding it together, Amir, is because they have been very prominent on social media. Again, they had a reality show around their coupledom, and that was super awkward if you watched
like
it, which I did.
Dumb.
Get out, get off the, get, no, you have to leave the set now. Guys, it's just me and you. So the couple recently shot down split rumors via Instagram from Higgins in February, following gossip that they had broken up because Bushnell's Instagram showed her celebrating her birthday traveling with girlfriends, sans Ben. Just a few days ago, Lauren was putting out sponsored content relating to their backyard design. That's pretty cringeworthy. And then also they had to host this thing on Freeform, which is where their reality show was. It was Disney weddings, and that was so awkward. Someone actually tweeted at Ben Higgins and they were like, "Wow, you and Lauren are so awkward hosting this wedding special for Disney weddings." And he was like, "Is it more awkward than prom photos? Because that's pretty awkward." Like, ba-do-doo. And I was like, "Oh God, you can't even deny that you guys aren't really together anymore." The reason why this is interesting and why I wanted to talk about it, and probably no one else wanted to talk about it, is because Reality Steve, who, if you are a part of Bachelor Nation, you know that he is sort of the guy that is, he is the one that knows all. He's sort of the big brother of Bachelor World, has said that this is the first of potentially multiple breakups in the Bachelorverse. So I speculate.
Really? Like, what a shocker. Sorry, keep going. What do you speculate?
I feel like you greenlit me to do this story just because you wanted to laugh.
Do you also speculate that the ocean is wet?
No, now you have to do the rest of the story.
In other news, The Bachelor is the highest rated program ever.
Really?
And it's nominated for 4 daytime Emmys.
Really?
This year, yeah.
Okay, well now I want to come back.
I just made all of that up.
Oh, damn it, I thought he actually prepared.
Like, yeah, sure.
Well, look, I love The Bachelor, but I will say that I've kind of come to expect that the love doesn't really
last. Are any previous Bachelor people still together?
Yeah, there are, well, recently People Magazine, who is affiliated with ABC, put out an issue, probably because they knew that a lot of these couples are about to break up, with the Bachelor couples from yesteryears that have stayed together and that have started families.
Yeah.
And one of them is, unfortunately, their names are now all escaping me. Ashley Hebert, is that one? Is that a name?
Yeah.
That's her. She married JP from the show and they have 2 kids together, and she is a dentist. Good for her. And then Trista and Ryan were the first bachelorette.
Why are you yelling at me?
Because the stories became goofy.
It didn't become goofy.
Trista and Ryan are married.
Here's the thing. Like, it's easy to make fun of all this shit. I actually think for the most part, they actually do try to make it work.
Yeah, because the pressure.
Yeah, and look, people who aren't on reality TV divorce all the fucking time. Like, it never works out. These people, like, they're on TV, they're getting paid to do it at the same time. And I do think they're sincerely trying most of the time. I'm sure there has been cases where they're not trying.
Yeah.
So it sucks, but there's gonna be way more Bachelors in the future.
Do you think that it hurts the Bachelor brand that they have so many couples break up?
If it hurt, like, it wouldn't exist at this point.
Do you know what I think it is? And this is why I think I'm still such an avid Bachelor fan, even though they break my heart all the time because they break up. Mm-hmm. Like, I remember watching this proposal and being like, oh, like they love each other, you know? And now they're done. And I think that it's actually kind of perfect because if you're a hopeless romantic like myself, you always hope, you always give them the benefit of the doubt, and they know exactly how to hook you in there. Like, it didn't work out this time, but love is real. Like, you just gotta believe, like Tinkerbell.
And it's a vicarious thrill just to see these people like come together.
Fall in love in 2 months. Yeah. Do you think that so you have a girlfriend and you guys have been together for a while. Do you think that if you were to meet her on a reality dating show that things would work out? Or even though
they would not, no.
You don't think so?
No.
Lizzie and I have talked about this, about if we met on, if there was a hybrid gay version of The Bachelorette, how would that work out? And I think I would choose her. But I don't.
You gotta eliminate any knowledge of Lizzie that you have right now.
Why?
And imagine you're just meeting her for the first time on this show.
I'd be terrified.
With many other potential mates, and it's exciting, and you're going through all of this, and all of a sudden you win, and you're with her, and all these eyes are on you, and you have all these other opportunities to be with other people.
Well,
there's too much to entice you from not choosing monogamy.
That's a fair point.
That's my opinion.
I think we would just go camping though. I think we'd be like, run away, like just go off the grid and being like, well, that's how the lesbian bachelorette should end, with them just like going off the grid and living in Canada as mountain women.
Yeah.
Like that's pretty much how it would go. Would you rather be a contestant or the Bachelor? Everyone's gonna be like they want to be the Bachelor.
Yeah, Bachelor.
Like, you wouldn't
I would lose if I was a contestant. Like I'd be eliminated in the first round.
You'd be like, what's your name? Amir? He's scary.
I don't know anything about these shows. Have they done
He's
one?
He's a terrorist. Would that be awful?
Yeah, it would be. It would be terrible. That would be racist. That's what that would be. No, here's what I wanted to say. What's the criteria for the contestants? Do they ever choose people who have a history of monogamy, or do they just like pick really attractive guys?
I thought you were gonna say a history of like
drug use, like drug abuse.
Yeah.
Who can keep it together? That's
honestly,
who wins. Like they put him in like a house with a lot of booze and drugs. You're like,
well, they do. They're all. I mean, if you watch the season, sometimes you'll watch an entire rose ceremony. I'm like, I think everyone's in a blackout at this point. I think they go back and forth. From what I understand, from the things that I've read, they have about five like wives or husbands and out of the pool of like 24 or 25. They're like, okay, these five are like, they have stable jobs, the good people, like well-rounded individuals, and they would make they're ready to find love.
What's their dating history though? I think that's super important. If you wanted a show to actually work, do like some conservative ass Bachelor show where like everyone has only had one or two, been in one and true relationships.
Why?
And all of them are virgins.
What?
Yeah.
Why?
Because
also, that might exist on like the Christian Bible network.
And the Bachelor, the Bachelorette is like super religious, and she's saving it for marriage.
Why?
Yeah, I'd be.
You would
that
never
show.
Get on that show.
Yeah, I would be. Come on, look at me. Like, of course I would.
Guys. This kind of went off the rails, but I hope you enjoyed it. We want to hear from you in the comments section below. Are you part of Bachelor Nation, or are you not like Amir? What are your views on finding love on a reality television program? Do you think it could ever work out? Don't forget to subscribe to this channel, and we will see you next time on Pop Trigger.